Hey, Spinnies. I thought I'd do another little vlog thing, excuse me. Since my last vlog, my body's hit a wall. And I was sitting here debating whether I should do this vlog or I should just, you know, continue to do the themed videos. But I did promise a look into Spinny's life, and I'm gonna deliver that. So, Friday, I made that video, I think, Wednesday, Thursday, somewhere's around there, and I didn't upload it until a couple days later. Because that's how things go. My body hit a wall. I woke up that Friday morning, supposing to go to my general surgeon appointment at 10 in the morning, and I couldn't. I called up, I woke up, and I got up, and I tried to move around, and I couldn't. So I called, canceled, and rescheduled, and my body has had me down since. My heel is getting worse. So the way it's acting right now, I'm back on using my cane. I'm not happy about that. The way it's looking, I should probably be up in crutches. But I can't do the traditional crutches because my underarms, which, by the way, my HS is out of remission in my left armpit. And right now it's just swollen and just trying to appear. And I'm trying everything I can to, like, make it go away. I've iced it. I've done all my tricks. I've stopped shaving. I didn't use any of my deodorants around the site. And it's just, it's there. So, it looks like the same general surgeon is going to do, which, by the way, the hernia that I thought I had is confirmed. So the same general surgeon is going to do that surgery. I see him again on the 26th. He said the HS lesion, sore, demon, whatever you want to call it, it's there. It hurts like hell. Is doing good. You know, right now we're just trying to find out if removing the most problemsome and most painful ones will work. So this one's just an experimental thing, and if it does work, well, there's treatment option. Just sadly involves me going under more procedures. This would be the second lesion I've had removed. The first one was back when I was 16, and that was on my tailbone. And that's the one that scared the living crud out of the previous general surgeon I was seeing. That guy was a god. I'm so sorry he retired. I am. But, so we're gonna wait and see if that works. If he got all of the cyst or sore or lesion, whatever you want to call this torturous condition. I don't want to say disease, because disease to me means you can pass this on, that it's easily transmittable to another person. It's not. It's genetics. So, yeah. I've just been flat on my back. I've, you know, this is the absolute worst time for my body to be falling apart, and it's so frustrating. It's so frustrating. I cannot describe how frustrating it is that I just recently learned how to juggle all my illnesses. I was just recently getting back into the gym and working on getting my health to where I'm healthy enough to where my body's gonna allow me to be healthy enough. And my ankle hernia and HS out of remission pops up. It's, as I explained in my past video, it's like whack-a-mole. It's a very frustrating game of whack-a-mole with my body. I never thought I'd be using my cane again. It's taken me 2 to 3 years to get used to having that not be an extension of my arm, and now I'm back at it. And it's hard because there's so many things that I need to do, and my body's forcing me to slow down again. I don't know whether I've pushed too hard or it's just gonna be the theme for the rest of my life. So, just to get an idea of what I'm gonna be dealing with my ankle, I did a little research, and if the pain isn't getting better, I'm hoping to go the physical therapy route because, maybe I won't be laid up for so long. But I have a gut feeling that it's gonna be surgery, and if it is surgery, I'm gonna be laid up for about 6 months. And that crutches. It's not easy having chronic illnesses. And that's another thing people will never, ever, ever understand. Some people will say, when you complain about something new, they're like, oh, suck it up. When you have chronic pain and you get something new that's painful, that's like the straw that broke the camel's back, man. I'm dealing with knee pain, I'm dealing with back pain, I'm dealing with HS pain, and here comes along my ankle. So that included with my back and knee and HS, it's almost intolerable. I always come on my videos, laughing and making jokes. And that's basically what every spoonie does, is they do it to, not be a downer. They do it to avoid hearing, oh, deal with it. Suck it up and put up. Or it's not, it can't be that bad. It's like, And I just had to tell my homegirl Angel and Kitty that I will not be able to make it up to see him this weekend. And there's a party for a friend's birthday, and can't make it. I don't think I'll be able to make the drive. I can't stay at Kitty's because there's two flights of stairs going up to his room. And I just doing the shopping Monday. Just doing the shopping Monday. My foot and my leg was so swollen and so painful. It's just, it's frustrating. And I'm not ashamed to admit that I just want to sit down and cry because I'm so frustrated. But I know crying, kicking, and screaming and throwing an adult tantrum ain't gonna fix anything. doctors, support, and myself are the ones that are going to fix it. Pardon me. Water. It's driving me crazy because I know this is going to affect my weight loss journey. You know, I know the more weight I get off of my body, the better it's going to be for my joints, the better it's going to be for my health. But how can I do that? You know, my ankle's messed up. Okay, there goes the bike. I have a hernia. Okay, there goes the weights. Any suggestions? Huh? That's what I thought. It's just... I have not hurt like this in years. I have not been this frustrated in years. And normally I'm up here poking jokes and laughing and trying to be upbeat, you know, because this channel is not about, oh, poor me, oh, pity me. No, it's about helping others, giving insight to people who are healthy that have a spoonie in their life. May it be a family member, a best friend, a coworker, a boss, you know, this is what it's like. You do everything the doctor tells you to. You do everything right, and your body still flips you off. You have zero choice in the matter. I had zero choice in the matter, you know, when I had to cancel my weekend with Kitty and Angel. So, I'm just sitting here with my leg up and relaxing and knitting. I was hoping to get this blanket knocked out. And the way I was doing that, and I know it's cheating. I know it's cheating, but it's a time crunch. So, it's the only time I use that thing. It's time crunch. I prefer doing it by hand. Keeps my mind more occupied. But, apparently my knit machine decided to flip me off, too. So, I have to, like, mid-project, mid-border, it decided to say, you know, I'm done. Yeah, you're doing this by hand, honey. Yay. It's just been that kind of week, I guess, kind of month. Oh, and I also, pardon the clouds, I also fixed my medical necklace, when I got in that car accident, which I don't think I told you guys about, sorry, I'm okay, car's okay, turned out I found out my Equinox is a mini tank, awesome, it would have been definitely Nana approved, of course I think my Nana kind of had a hand in protecting me from most of the damage. My family is a believer of the unseen, and, empaths run in our family. So, yeah. But, after I tell you about the necklace, I'll tell you about the car accident. But, anyways. I got my medical necklace. Because the way people were driving, I was getting pretty freaked out. Like, what if I got in a serious accident and the paramedics didn't know about my hip replacement, didn't know about me being on warfarin, aka blood thinners for life, and, you know, I'm sitting there bleeding out and they don't know what to do. It's things you constantly think of. So, you're gonna see the photobomber again. You can tell him home. But, so I went and I ordered these dog tags. I can't take the bracelets. I've tried wearing bracelets, I have, but they annoy me, especially when I'm using a cane or I'm in the wheelchair. It's just I can't wear them. So I went for the dog tags, and they have my medical information on there and the two people they need to contact. Sadly, there wasn't room for my heart sister Tabby. But she is on my emergency contacts in on my advance directive. And yes, I already have advance directive. The way things are going, I'm starting to wonder if I should have a living will. Ugh. But anyways, I had this when I got into that car wreck. It was a couple months ago. And I was heading up to Santa Rosa, and just off of Mendocino Avenue. It was stop and go traffic. So I was stopped there, and the car behind me was stopped. I'm like, okay, I'm just sitting there waiting for traffic to go. I was grabbing a vape, and usually when I grab my vape, it's like right. I keep it like right in the little cup holder so I can just grab without looking. And all of a sudden, I feel this jerk. And I hear this crash. And my coffee went everywhere in the car. And I was like, what the hell just happened? And then it hit me. I was rear-ended. The force of the impact caused these to fly off the metal chain that they were originally on. And I expected the back of my Equinox to be gone. I didn't expect the hatch to open, nothing. But my main concern was the people behind me. Thankfully, I always stop. Like in stop and go traffic, I always give myself some wiggle room in case I am rear-ended. So I didn't hit the person in front of me. I just went and pulled over. I wasn't really hurting at the time, and that's the weird thing with my body is like I don't hurt that day if something really bad happens. It's usually the coming days that I do. So like the next day I was a little sore, and then the coming week I was in like can't move. But anyways, I pulled over the car, went rushing. The car behind me was a little car. So I think it was like a little Honda or something. It was old. I'd give you like around 90s type car. So it was the major truck behind that car that rear-ended us. So the people in the red car were sitting down outside. I rushed over to see if everyone was okay. And then I inspected my car. But, not a single scratch on that car. The car behind me, well, they're missing a hood and some of an engine. And, the person behind me, like behind us, just was like inspecting her nails and shit. And if I hadn't been so freaked out and trying to get to Kitty and Angel's, I probably would have ripped her a new one. But obviously I'm fine. I just had some whiplash and some soreness in my back, and everything's fine. And I always joked with my family that, you know, if I ever get in a wreck, I trust my driving. I have loved driving ever since I was little. Like race games, and I always paid attention to my nana's driving, my dad is driving, my mom's driving. I just absolutely loved cars. So I just always loved cars. Loved them, loved them, loved them. So I just, I forgot where I was going with that. I swear I'm not on pain medication right now. It's just spoony brain. It's spoony brain. Oh, yeah, swearing. Anyways, I always swear to my family, it's my driving I trust. It's not ev it's everyone around me that I'm concerned about. And when my nana taught me how to drive, she told me, "You're not just driving your car, you're driving everyone else's car." That means the car coming at you, the car beside you, the car behind you, the car in front of you, the car that's trying to merge into oncoming traffic from a side street. You're controlling those cars. You need to predict what they're gonna do. And that was the best advice ever. And I noticed everyone's driving, it's just gotten so. I don't know if they're driving with their heads up their ass, really. But I've been noticing a lot of horrible driving lately. It's scary. I had one car when I was on State Street in town at a stoplight. I was going to turn right so I can get onto the freeway and head home. And this white car comes up beside me. I'm in the correct lane. So the white car comes up beside me. I'm like, oh, maybe they're gonna, stop by and pick up some oranges because there's a little stand on that side. And they're selling oranges and fruits and stuff. I'm like, oh, maybe they're just gonna park there. That's cool. So when the light turned green, I went to go, and the car dashed out beside me and made a left-hand turn. And that was it. That was the moment I decided to get a medical necklace. But yeah, I've always loved driving. In fact, the pizza place that used to be here, I think it was used to be Treasure Cove, and then it went over to Paradise Pizza, and sadly, they went out of business. It's now a Planet Smoothie. But when they took that little race car arcade game out, with the wheel and the pedals, the little 2D old tech Pac-Man-like thing, I was still top score. And technically, I've been driving since I was 14. Like, I think one of my bucket lists is get like one of those 67 Chevys, or Impalas, and just race like straight open road and just floor that baby. But yeah. So, let's see, I'm trying to think what else is going on. Oh, my mom's wound is looking amazing. They just took the staples out. They took the wound back out, so she's able to get around better. Let's see what else. Oh yeah, tomorrow's her tattoo day. And then we're gonna see when I'm gonna get an appointment with the piercer to get my eyebrow done, so I can distract from this. I think that's gonna be the only facial piercing I'm gonna get, is like the eyebrow, maybe like get the two eyebrow, like the double eyebrow piercing. But I wanna get this one and see how well that heals. Because I've had my ears pierced in the past and my body just went ape. And my body wasn't having it. Of course, I was a dumbass, an impatient dumbass, and got six holes at once. And not factoring in on how busy my life was with doctor's appointments and life. Yeah, it wasn't pretty. So, figured if I can get this to heal, I can get my ears redone. Wait for those to heal and get the piercings I want. But yeah, this is what happens on your body forcing you to stop. There's no choice in the matter, you know, and most likely people don't see. That's my girl Angie. I'm gonna end this video. And, alright, Angel. Oh my god. Hi, honey, give me 1 second, okay?
Okay.
Okay, I need to end this video real fast. Anyway, Spoonies, I'm gonna end this video, and, I'll keep you all updated. Let me know if you like these vlogs or not, or if I should keep doing them in addition to my themed videos of, you know, what to talk about. And, I hope you have a flare-free day, and a pain-free day, even though I know that's like a mystical unicorn. Bye, guys.